Hello guys, welcome to the next video. This is another Garen matchup. So quickly on screen, here are the runes that I am running for this this matchup. Fairly standard. Garen, pretty good matchup. And yeah, he's running Ignite Flash, which most Garens would probably end up doing. Yeah, he's looking to play aggressive. We're playing in Emerald, High Plat Emerald, right now. So yeah. Also, for those of you who are in my Discord, you will already know this. But for me right now, it's currently not really sustainable for me to upload matchup videos every weekday, which is what I was doing previously. Because I'm busy with work, and also I don't want to burn myself out playing League at the moment. You know, I'm not enjoying it as much as I used to right now, and I don't want this to become a chore, uploading these videos. So yeah, so I'm gonna upload every Tuesday and every Thursday, for the time being anyway. You know, that might change, but for now, every Tuesday, every Thursday, I'm gonna upload. And we'll go from there, yeah. So, new matchup video, twice a week. Yeah, and it'll be around afternoon for Europe. 3 o'clock, preferably, but I know this video is going to go up a little bit later today. But yeah, cool. So, let's get into the video. Right, nothing really to watch out for early game in this matchup, except for the Jarvan. We have a fairly full clear jungler, whilst enemy jungler looks, you know, he can look for early level 3 ganks. We have pretty decent scaling this game with Camille, Kindred, Aesol. Our bot lane possibly will struggle this game, but yeah, let's have a look. So Jarvan's likely to start red. Turn this up a little bit. Jarvan's likely to start red, which means it's definitely possible for him to do a level 3 gank. So we need to ward him and watch for this. Little ward on the Tribush early. I quite like doing it here. This is always nice. But if you do it here, you can see if they're hovering in this area. If you're planning on overextending, they can hide in the fog of war here. And if I'm fighting here, Jarvan can get an EQ off out of vision and they won't see me. But I'm not planning on pushing early just for this reason. I don't want to get level 3 ganked. So warding it here means we get to see more of this area down here. Okay, and we're going to make sure the wave pushes to us. Their bot lane's not leashing. They're doing the exact same thing. So that means Jarvan is starting red. So we definitely don't want to be pushing early game. We want to be ready for Jarvan to come. And we can potentially deny a minion with this. I didn't quite do it properly. But yeah, right. So, obviously, we win this matchup 1v1. Just got to make sure we don't get beaten by Jarvan. I haven't started any ability yet because I'm a bit concerned about getting ganked and not having E to get away. But he's not level 2-ing. If he decides to level 3 gank, that's one thing, but we'll be level 2 by then. Okay, just gotta keep watching the map. Okay, Kindred's invading, so he's definitely full clearing. This means Jarvan's either on Raptors or Krogs right now. Potentially Wolves, but he's not gonna be that quick. Unless he's doing a really weird clear, is it like red to Raptors to Wolves or something. Or he's coming to invade our blue side and kill Kindred on blue, which means that he could actually be down here. Okay, nice, he's not. So Jarvan ended up full clearing his top side. And he lost it all, which is really big. But a tip, because we didn't know whether Jarvan was, you know, like exactly where he was. He could have been invading us. If we're hovering up here, rather than down here, we have more room to escape from a Jarvan early game. And that's not just Jarvan, that's anyone, right? Early game. Okay, let's make sure we get all this. We do give Garen a bit of a free reset. And we didn't play as aggressively as I would normally like to play in this matchup especially, because it is one of Camille's few winning matchups. But, you know, there's not much you can do. You don't want to die to a Jarvan gank, you know. There's no point. We know we have to play careful early game, and that's the difference between, you know, higher and lower elos. They'll play the same every game. If it's, especially if it's an easy matchup, people tend to get quite complacent. He didn't reset for some reason. He had a free reset. He hasn't got TP either. I'm gonna get passive up soon and we'll beat him. Okay, he's dead. He flashed as well. Okay, that's no sums for this guy. I'm gonna make sure we get this cannon minion. Actually, yeah, I don't need to take this cannon. I'm gonna just keep the wave here because he hasn't got TP, he can't TP back. He's really fucked. Oh, but I mean, there's stuff going on here, but I'm 1 HP, man. I had to keep my wave set up. I have TP. There's a big ass wave for this. Sake. Yeah, it's fine. We're still ahead of Garen. He lost a lot as well. But the wave crashed because of this. Could have kept the wave here forever. Which would have been nice. Oops. I mean, you just ignored me. Alright, so the wave right now is going to slow push to his tower. Which could potentially be a problem because Jarvan was topside, but he was also really low on health. So he might be okay. And he's only level 3. Can actually probably kill him if he comes, but oops, he ran into me there. That's fine. Get a little trade off. Problem is, it's Garen, so he's gonna regenerate. Okay, so we slow push this wave to start with, and now we can hard push it here. The reason you do that is so you're not stuck trying to crush the wave when it's hovering here. Because you're in a really dangerous spot then, especially if the jungle is here. The wave is a lot easier to crash now. We don't have to step under his tower to crash this wave. It's a shame the minions won't hit him if he hits me on the tower now. Since the new changes. But we get a reset here. Well, the wave is going to push back to me now. Jarvan could be here. To give up a couple of early ECS. His wave is gonna push to me. I don't mind missing a couple of minions. Oh, I didn't get my Q. But this is really good. Now the wave is fucked for him. And Kindred is bot side. I mean, Jarvan's bot side. Now he's really screwed. He can't do much here. You're not getting that cannon. Nope. Nope. So we don't touch the wave. We just let it slow push. Okay, Jarvan's bot side, but there is Kindred's mark up here. That's Kindred not going for that. He was on Drake. Okay, Okay, so that means Jarvan is going to be rushing for this to deny Kindred the mark. So, we're probably he's probably going to end up coming to help help Garen crush this wave. We're a whole level on this guy. He's just hit 7. We're about to hit 8. And we have this wave, big wave in front of us. They're probably on Rift Herald. But if Andy's there, with Jarvan and Garen silence, I can't even like step up and face check. Don't have a ward. We know they're on it. We know they're on it. But they're not on it. What are they doing? Where are you? What? Oh man. Fuck's sake. And now we're a bit fucked. And he's still mid. We're not going to be able to get this wave crushed. Because we don't have a ward. Holy damage, I got the ignite off. Oh, and I got the kill, perfect. Why? Why do we have to do that? Sell that, get our early spike. That wave would have eventually built off a big slow push towards me. Because there's only a couple of minions here, so eventually would have slow pushed in. I guess it's not that bad. He gets the crush for free, but me being greedy, you know. Bot lane's fairly even. Garen got the kill on me, but I actually traded because I ignited just before his ult went off. That's nice that I got the kill, to be honest. Okay, Jarvan and Annie go on bot side so we can E in aggressively. Okay, I want to crash this wave. Because I could potentially TP if there's something that happens here. What? Okay, free play. Almost 2 levels on this guy. He's just hit 8. We're about to hit 10. Just from better wave management. We've not really killed him much. Okay, nice. Get off me, bitch. He gets a couple of plates, but I didn't TP straight away. I wanted to make sure I wasn't TPing in range of Garen. Didn't want him to silence me and interrupt me. Okay, nice. He gets 2 plates for that. That's fine. We've already got 2 plates. And we get 2 kills. Which is nice. We actually managed to last hit the Kalista and get the kill on Annie. Is really good. Okay. Only problem is now I don't have TP for this Drake fight. But I doubt Garen's going to run to it. We might be able to get one or two plates here. We're lucky Garen runs to the Drake fight. And then we just get... Oh, we're running out of time there. We can get two plates. This is really nice. Oh, we actually get the Drake. Maybe. No. Not happening. Garen still does a bit of base damage. Quite a bit of high damage. Can't disrespect him and just hit the tower without the minions there. But now we can hit this. Okay. Who's coming? Surely it's not top. It is top. Still with it. Oh, they actually killed our team. I just wanted to stay for this. It was really greedy. I can sell this now though. We got a tower. We can probably get this. Yeah, that was bad then. That's a bounty to Annie. They killed our team around Drake. Thought Annie would have at least altered. Okay, our jungler's very outclassed this game. Not FFing though. Yeah, we have two items now. So we're strong. New bot. Wait, our AD DC'd. Oh, they're back now though. Actually, rage quit. I'm so toxic in this elo, man. This is why I don't like playing League at the moment. We scale, relax, calm. To babysit these guys. I'm dead. I don't have ult. If I had ult there, I'd be fine. We should get this for free though. Neither of their bot lanes here. If they fight this, they're griefing. Kindred, press R, man. Get two towers bot. Maybe even three here. God. That hit. I entered. Well, you're not running for this bounce here. I mean, we get the bounce here. Should just run in here. Like, that's a huge bounty. I don't know why she doesn't want it. Got a bit of CC, need this. My bad, I wanted to try and kite them. I wanted to get in and dodge the stun. You know, just like stall for the team, but I got hit. I think Caitlyn's soft inting, which is a bit of a shame. That's a free bounty. I tired of feeling like I'm living in a ghost town. Okay, we need to try and transition our lead to win this game. That team is really struggling. Can't fight this stroke. If I can get this top tower. Aesop is scaling. Oh, Aesop is scaling. We're gonna die for this stroke. Yeah. I don't listen to the pings, so we will outscale them. We just don't want to. I don't know what this unnecessarily fighting is right now. Oh, nice wave clear, man. Nice wave clear, bro. God, that's annoying. Frozen Heart, a lot of CC, a lot of healing. Love to give. Okay, his Annie is really strong. Kind of makes me want to go more next, but the Jarvan's also strong. Hullbreaker is probably the best bet here. Give us good mixed stats. Why is everyone? I don't know what's going on this game. These guys are so bad. I don't think they're on Baron. Kalista's not there. Yeah, like Aesop is getting big, man. Aesop is getting big. We can win this. Thank God that Kalista didn't go for Baron. They could have 100% done that. Probably on it now though, because Caitlyn's down there. No? Okay, it's dead. Flushed as well. Jovan's on it. Okay, we got him off it. That is not how you play Kindred. How are we dying? Exhaust, man! Can you you TP, guys. Focus, we can win. Why, what's wrong with you? What's wrong with these guys? We can literally win this game. I stood for so long. If I didn't get exhausted there, I'd kill Jarvan as well. This guy flashed and exhausted on me. I'm still losing. Okay. They have Annie down there, that's good. Wait, they're all on Drake, do this shit. They're chasing Azul. He's dead though. Yeah, that's fine though. Very nice. What were they doing for that? Stay near this hex portal to be able to teleport out. Come for a flank. Hopefully my team doesn't die before I get there. What are you doing? Just running it down. Have we win the game here? Nice. Don't want Garen to clear the wave. They have double frozen heart for some reason. Wait, what? Annie? Oof! My bad, I guess. Thought we could have fought a bit better. Fought a bit longer. Goomba weak, Garen. 1k, lol. Handle it. These guys are top, so they can't even get anything for this. What do you mean? Do I need this much for my Asterix? Death dance last. Okay, I needed that. You're gonna FF because I took the cannon, I pinged it. Okay. Alright, now I wanna be bot lane. No, team. They haven't got a wave. I can't end because I took the wave. If someone walks up, maybe I can kill them. How about though? That really hit me. Okay, that's good. That's Annie's dead. What? What? Zyra? Zyra just jumped in to sacrifice herself. Whatever, me killing Annie's huge though. Okay. Actually, I think this is better. The game's gonna end before I get Death Stance, I think. Okay, I've done a lot of this game actually, I don't like it. But the game felt very weird. I've been done a lot recently, to be honest. That's because I'm not as, as good as I used to be. I'm a bit washed. Just used to not playing so much. But yeah, the reason when they all got caught here, take this midwave. They can't take this tower without minions. So no matter, even if my team got ace, they can't do anything. Come. My Caitlyn is soft inting, man. She's always just staying away from the Baron. Hello, click it, please. Hello? What the fuck? Really? How is my team dying? Okay, nice. Carried that. Ace, I played well this game at least. I used my W, like QW, but she jumped over the wall, so I couldn't hit her with it. But she doesn't have shield bow, which is nice. God, this Caitlyn. God damn. Well, yeah, I mean, showed you good laning phase, how to play a matchup, how to respect jungle pressure, you know, early. We won the lane with a bit of a struggle like jungle mid early because Annie was perma roaming and our Caitlyn was a bit of a mental patient, but hopefully that game helped. So yeah, thanks for watching guys, and I'll see you in the next video on Thursday. Bye.